Welcome to the second lecture of trigonometry, and today we are going to discuss allied angles. So two angles are said to be allied when their sum or difference is either 0 degree or a multiple of 90 degree. Like 90 plus or minus theta, 180 degree plus or minus theta, 270 degree plus or minus theta, 360 degree plus or minus theta are the allied angles of theta. Let's say I take theta and 180 degree plus theta. So either their sum or a difference of these two is a multiple of 90 degree, then we say these two angles are allied angles. So here you can write theta plus 180 degree plus theta. So we are not sure about it whether I'll get a multiple of 90 degree. But when I write 180 degree plus theta, and that I subtract theta, I will definitely be getting a multiple of 90 degree, which is 180 degree. So that means theta and 180 degree plus theta are the allied angles. Similarly, you can take other angles also. You can take 270 degree minus theta, and then you can take 90 degree plus theta, and simply by adding you will get a multiple of 90 degree. So these two are the allied angles. So in this lecture we will discuss how we can find the values of the allied angles. So I think the definition of the allied angle is clear to you. So here you can see I have drawn different triangles there. The triangle O is the origin there. This is the x-axis and this is y-axis. And you already know if you move to the right, you always get the positive values on the x-axis. If you move left, you get negative values. And if you move up, you get positive y, move down, negative y. So you can see the triangle OAB here. Let's say I take this value is A there. And the length AB I have taken as a small a. And OA I have taken as a small b. So obviously the OB's value will be under root of A square plus B square. So which is going to be positive. And this way that OB dash's value, if I take this value A dash B dash, A dash B dash will be minus A. And this OA dash is minus B. But if I find the OB dash will be under root of A square plus B square only. Similarly, here you can see that OA double dash in this triangle you can see. Here I have taken OA double dash as a small a. And this A double dash B double dash value is minus B. But if I find OB double dash, I'll get a square root of A square plus B square. That is A is square plus minus B is square. So we can see, observe that OB, OB dash and OB double dash, these all are equal. Now if I find the value of, let's say this angle, the angle AOB, I have taken as a theta. So if I find the value of sine of theta, for a while I'm taking under root of A square plus B square, just for the simplification I have taken as a 1 unit. So sine theta's value I'll get A divided by under root of A square plus B square, which I have taken as a 1. So A by 1, that is equals to A. Now I find the sine of 180 degree plus theta. So how to get the value of sine of 180 degree plus theta? See, this is theta, and when I rotate by 180 degree, when I rotate this OB by 180 degree, you can see BOB dash, these all are collinear. And this angle, the rotation, this complete angle will become 180 degree plus theta. So in this triangle, you can observe, if I try to get the value of sine of 180 degree plus theta, you see there, this will become minus A because it is down there. So sine of 180 degree plus theta's value, if I find, so I'll get minus a divided by under root of a square plus b square, which is 1 I have taken. So sine of 180 degree plus theta's value, I'll get minus a, and sine theta's value was a. So that means if I write sine of 180 degree, I can write sine of 180 degree plus theta is equals to minus sine theta. So we can conclude when I rotate by 180 degree, sine of 180 degree plus theta will become minus sine theta. And similarly, we can observe the other values also, cos 180 degree plus theta, tan 180 degree plus theta. I'll be telling you one trick, but before that trick, I just want to tell you how we actually getting all these trigonometric ratios of the allied angles. And one more example I have taken here, and this blue angle you can see, I have taken this as a 270 degree plus theta. So now 270 degree plus theta, let's say we try to get the tan of 270 degree plus theta. What the value of tan of 270 degree plus theta's value I have to find. So as I have taken this angle as a theta, so it has to be 90 minus theta. This angle has to be 90 degree minus theta. And you observe in this triangle OAB, I have taken this angle as theta. So this is 90 degree minus theta. So in order to get the same triangle over there, the side adjacent to 90 degree minus theta, I just took as A there. So you can see this is A there. I have taken this as A there. And A double dash, B double dash, I have taken as a minus B there. Okay, this change I have done there. The base is no more A there. In these two triangles, the base was B there. Now the base I have changed and it has taken as A there. So tan of 270 degree plus theta, if I try to get there. So this angle I'll be finding there. And in that case, you see, I'll be getting minus B divided by A there. This is minus B and this is A. So tan of 270 degree plus theta, I'll get minus B by A. Now we'll again go back to our first triangle there. What is the value of B by A? So if you see B by A, this is a B and this is A. So B by A is basically cot theta. So that means 270 degree plus theta is equals to minus cot theta. So this is a basic idea behind the allied angles, how we get these allied angles. So now I'll tell you one trick and how we can find these values easily there. So there is a one circle there. Let's say this is our origin, 0, 0. So this side we get plus, and this side we get minus, and this up we go, we get positive there, and down this is a negative. So any triangle if I draw there in the first quadrant, see in the coordinate system when we move left or right or go up and down, in that case we get the value plus or minus, but if I move in any oblique direction, we always get the positive values. Okay, so I have taken the radius, let's say is radius of this circle, I have taken as a 1 unit. So any triangle I draw in a first quadrant there, let's say this is O, this is A, this is B. So you can see all the values or all the sides are positive there. So any kind of a trigonometric ratio I find there. So this is positive, it has to be positive. This is positive there. So any trigonometric ratio I find in the first quadrant, in that case, you'll observe that has to be positive there. Whether I find the sine theta is positive divided by positive, that is positive. Tan theta, cot theta, any value you find there, you will get positive there. So we write A. A means all the trigonometric ratios are positive in the first quadrant. Now I come to the second quadrant. In second quadrant, this base is going to be negative there, which I have already mentioned there. You can see this is negative there. This is positive going up, and this is positive. So in all those trigonometric ratios where I will get the perpendicular and the hypotenuse will remain positive, rest all the trigonometric ratios are going to be negative, because you can see this is positive and this is positive. So those trigonometric ratios which involve exclusively perpendicular and the hypotenuse are going to be positive, and these, you know, the sine and the reciprocal of sine, which is cosine. So in second quadrant, sine theta and cosecant theta are positive in second quadrant. Now we come to the third quadrant. So any triangle I draw in third quadrant, this is already negative, this is going to be negative, this is positive. So you see those trigonometric ratios which involve base and perpendicular are going to be positive, because negative upon negative is positive. So those trigonometric ratios which involve base and the perpendicular will be positive. So these are tan and cot. So in the third quadrant, tan theta and cot theta are positive. Rest all are negative. Now we come to the fourth quadrant. In fourth quadrant, you can see this is positive. This base is positive, but this is negative. So all those trigonometric ratios in which the involvement of base and hypotenuse is there will be positive. Rest all are negative. So we know this is cos and sec. So cos theta and sec theta are positive. Now the trick, this is the one part of the trick. So what we can remember, this is ASTC, means all the trigonometric ratios are positive between 0 to 90 degree. Sine and cosec are positive between 90 to 180 degree. Tan and cot are positive between 180 to 270 degree. Rest all are negative. Between 270 degree to 360 degree, cos and sec are positive. Rest all are negative. So anyway, after any number of rotation you take and you reach at any in the coordinate, you just find out whether the answer, let's say I try what will be the answer of sine of 405 degree. So whether it is positive, as of now I am just discussing what whether it is positive or negative. So for 405 degree, you just check the location. I complete a one cycle, we get 360 degree, and then we add 45 degree, we get 405 degree. So that has to be positive. So the whatever answer I get, that has to be positive. Let's say you are asked the tan 765 degree. This answer will be positive or negative. So we'll check whether where the tan 765 degree lies. So this is 360 degree. 90 is 450. One more 90 I add. 540. 540. Then I add this 96. 630. Then I add one more 90. 720 and 720 plus 45. Finally, it comes in the first quadrant. There it has to be positive there. Let's say you are asked the tan of 600 degrees. It will be positive or negative. So this is 180, 360, and then 540. So 540 degree, in that if I add 60 degree, I reach in the third quadrant where the tan is positive. So this answer has to be positive. So we'll first find out the location, and accordingly we'll check whether it is, the answer will be positive or negative. Then one more very simple and important trick is there, that this along the horizontal line, function remains same, and along the vertical line, function becomes its co-function. So what are the function and co-function? Sine's co-function, sine theta's co-function is cos theta. Cos theta's co-function is sine theta. Tan theta's co-function is cot theta. We say cotangent. So cot theta's co-function is tan theta. Sec theta's co-function is cosec theta. Cosec theta's co-function is sec theta. So this thing you have to remember. Along the horizontal line, the function remains same. Along the vertical line, the function becomes its co-function. It's very easy to Understand. We just draw here line. This coordinates I make just. Let's say you're asked to find the value of tan of 225 degrees. So first you break in those angles. So you just write that tan of 225 degree. You can write 180 degree plus 45 degree. So now you see where this 180 degree, where it lies. So this is 180 degree is lying on the horizontal line. So that means our answer is going to be tan only. So you'll write plus or minus whatever this thing is written. You just write that's a tan. So tan of 45 degree, I'm going to get the answer. And now as it lies in the third quadrant, and in the third quadrant, I just told you that the tan's value is positive. So the final answer has to be tan of 45 degree. And similarly, if you are asked the tan of 180 minus 45 degree, let's say 135 degree. So that you can write tan of 180 degree minus 45 degree. So you'll again, you see the reference line is a horizontal line, and the function in that case, the function remains same. So I'll write the answer tan of 45 degrees. So because of this negative, don't write any sign positive or negative. You just check the location of that particular angle in the quadrant, and accordingly the trigonometric ratio will be positive or negative. So this 135 lies in the second quadrant where the tan's answers are negative. So I'll write minus tan 45 degree. Let's say you are asked secant 675 degree. So secant 675 degree can be written as a 630 degree plus 45 degree. So we'll check where it lies first. So you see this is a 360, 450, 540, 630. And after 630 we reach in the fourth quadrant, and in the fourth quadrant cos and sec are positive. Second, you can see the line is vertical there, so along the vertical line the function will remain same. So we'll write the answer sec 45 degree. As you know, there in the fourth quadrant cos and sec are positive, so we'll write plus answer. Since this 675 you can also write as a sec of 720 degree. You can write 720 degree minus 45 degree also. So whichever suits you can write it. So few more examples I'll take. Let's say you are asked sine of 1080 degree plus 30 degree. So you are asked sine of 1120 degree. So sine of 1120 degree. So one circle we complete 360. One more circle we'll complete. This is 720. In 720, if I add 90, this is 720 degree. This is 810 degree. This is 900 degree, and this is 1080 degree. So in 900, sorry, this will be 990. I'm sorry. This is 990 degree, and in 990, if I add, so I'll get 1080 degree. This one. So in 720, after adding 360, you'll get 108 degree, and then we add 30 degree there. So this is 30 degree. So we come to the first quadrant, line is horizontal, so their answer will become sine of 30 degree. Let's say you are asked here this cos of 870 degree, this value you are asked here. So you can see there. It can be written as a cos of 810 degree plus 60 degree. And you just see this 810 degree lies on the vertical line. So function will become its cofunction. So cos's cofunction is sine. So we'll write sine 60 degree. And it lies in the second quadrant. 800 plus 60 will be in the second quadrant. And in the second quadrant, cos values are negative. So our answer is minus sine 60 degree. So I hope it is clear to you. And one more way to get these results, I'll be telling you in the next lecture. So bye-bye.